Okay, give me one sec. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna start the stream soon. I wanna see if you can hear the fireworks in the background. No, you can't. Okay, that's all good. I just wanna make sure that you can hear the fireworks in the background. We're all good. Let's see. Let's get it started. We're gonna do. I think I decided I wanted to do the Gorefest one. Well, good morning, Fuzzy. How are you? I was gonna wait for Luna to get in. Don't know if she's here. Just woken up. Yeah, I did see that you had said that in the chat, or the group chat recently. Perfect timing in it. Power indeed. Well, welcome both of y'all. I appreciate it. Rip. Oh, one second. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and start it for now. Because, that's all good. I don't know if y'all can hear the fireworks in the background. Hopefully not. But we'll see if they pop up in the stream. It just be like that sometimes. I was like so confused for a second. Hold on, that's one thing I needed to do. Copyrighted music, that's cool. Okay, let me do that real fast. I need to do something else. All audio to the headset. That was the two things I forgot. I was like, I need to do two things before I stream, and I literally forgot both of them. It'd be like that. Okay, we're fixed now. I'm home. play this isn't the copyrighted music still. But it's going to be a movie, so it's just going to be, you know, me commentating over a movie, because what better thing can I do than commentate over something that's supposed to be a movie? So this is the Gorefest version, so it's going to be very gruesome and dark. Yes, it is actually. It is basically, so it's actually made, it's the same company that did Until Dawn. You just missed my full playthrough. I finished last night, the game. But it's exactly like Until Dawn. I did the Gorefest version just so that we could see all of the goriest options. Oh, good, Luna. But yeah, Marika, it's about, it's like camp counselors, but an Until Dawn version of the camp counselor. It's similar to it, but not the same creatures, is what I'll say. Since I was told not to say the name by a certain someone.
Why'd you kill the music?
I think you know why.
I don't think I do.
It begins with an L? Like the L word?
Lesbians?
Lost, Max. We're lost.
We're in geographic flux.
Right, so lost.
That's debatable.
Oh, heads up.
Nice catch there, hon.
I'm not the one who hit the pothole.
Well, maybe the pothole hit us. Ever think about that?
Wow, yes. That is like Olympic level goalpost moving.
Thank you.
Very impressive.
Thank you.
Basically, but not Wendigo.
Still totally lost. You know what, Max? It's okay. It doesn't make you any less of a man.
You know, if Columbus hadn't gone lost and landed on these golden shores, there would be no United States of America. Goodbye, hot dogs. See you later, apple pie.
Columbus never actually landed in North America.
What are you talking about?
This is facts.
Didn't even know he wasn't in Asia.
Are you serious?
Just another guy who didn't want to admit he was lost.
Well, just another guy who's got a whole day named after him, so put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Oh my god. Okay, just get us to camp already before I roll my eyes out of my head, please.
I'm working on it.
You're not wrong there, Fuzzy. Well, neither one of y'all are. Which one did she choose?
Voila.
What is that?
Yeah.
No, but seriously, how will happen to the normal map?
This is the normal map.
The one on the phone.
Okay, buddy.
No bars.
Of course not.
Okay, let's see. So we are... Well, I guess they don't put summer camps on maps. Have you seen any signs for it? Hey, eyes on the road!
Laura is very sassy, that is true.
Max!
I bet it's gonna like... Oh, there's the creepy lady.
Stop the car!
He hits right over it. It's gonna be all of the worst options possible, I feel like. But it's not everyone dies. This is like the goriest possible like events that could happen in the entire thing. So I don't think everyone dies, but I also don't know what the gory part is going to be.
Jesus Christ, what do you think that was? A bear?
What? No, Max, it wasn't a bear.
What was it?
I think it was a person.
Laura, are you serious? Do you think we hit a person?
I don't know. I mean, it was really close, like, really close, but maybe we didn't... What is it?
Yeah, this is true. I wonder if it's gonna be, like, just one person survives.
Well, maybe it looks worse than it is?
I should check out the damage before we try to start it up again, huh? Could you grab my, the toolbox from the trunk?
Yeah, okay.
It's all good, Luna. Yeah, you're not wrong there.
It's not so bad.
My mom's gonna kill me.
I don't know who would survive or not.
Why didn't you tell me?
Thanks, hon.
Yeah. Do you need a hand?
Yeah, actually, if you could just shine a light right here.
There you go.
Perfect, thank you.
The sooner we get out of here, the better.
Just picture yourself curling up in front of a big old fire pit singing campfire sing-alongs.
I don't think people curl up right in front of big old fire pits.
Why not?
They don't want to catch on fire.
And then picture yourself curling up in front of a big old space heater.
He probably is about to.
Well, anywhere's better than here.
Where are you going?
Just over here.
Just stay there for a second, okay? I'm almost done.
What? You're not the boss of me.
I just don't want you wandering off on your own.
Excuse me.
That's not what I meant.
Yeah, it better not be.
I'm sorry. I really got to concentrate for a second, okay?
Yes. Look, I think there's someone down there, okay?
What's that?
They could be hurt. I'm gonna go check it out.
I'm gonna try not to talk too much, like too much through what they say, but.
Good idea, Laura. So thoughtful of you.
This is true. You're not wrong. Wait, do I, like, walk the character around? Hold on. Oh, no. Okay. I was about to say, I was like, am I gonna be the one who walks the character around? What's going on here? Oh, it's like making it an actual movie. So it's like cutting out all of the walking scenes to where it, like, literally just teleports her over there. That's kind of interesting. Kind of abrupt. Absolutely right there. Ground is definitely winning over Laura.
Yikes. This is too weird.
The fact that it's teleporting her is kind of weird though. This is true. Oh, I absolutely love Uncharted. Oh, did you see the light in the spooky lady? Absolutely agree. Definitely gonna make for some funny moments. Like she's probably gonna slip and fall again, I don't even remember. Maybe she can hit her head on the tree, I'm sure. That's probably really loud. Dang. It's ground 3, or nature in general 3, Laura 0, my goodness.
Max? Max? Max!
Hey, hey, why are you shouting?
Oh my God.
What?
Silas.
What the hell was that?
Well, that was interesting.
Car. Now. Now.
Okay.
Did you see it?
No, but I heard something.
Yeah, it's because I'm not insanely good in doing it all for her. I'm just kidding.
Come on.
Oh, God, I thought you said you checked it.
I did check it, and it was fine. Honey, I know you're on edge, but you gotta calm down, okay?
I am not on edge, Max. I'm freaking the fuck out.
It was probably just an animal or
no,
something.
No, it wasn't an animal. You didn't see it. It was a woman.
Lord, this isn't helping, all right? Go. There we go. We're good. See?
Please just get us out of here.
Okay.
Max!
I'm trying.
We're okay. We're safe in the car, really. We're gonna be okay.
Jesus!
Oh, fuck! Oh my God, my heart just exploded.
Roll it down.
Hi, officer. How are you doing this evening?
Are either of you injured?
No. Well, she bumped her head.
Well, barely bumped it. I mean, I can't even feel it. My bump, not my head. I'm fine.
Really, we're fine. We're just a little shaken up.
Well, this is interesting. She had, like, mud or blood all over her. I can't tell.
Do you folks want to tell me what happened here?
Well, we were just driving, and it's really, really dark out here. And, I don't know, we must have hit, like, a pothole or something, because we swerved, and now here we are. I mean, these roads are really not in great shape.
Yeah.
Sir?
Exactly.
Sir?
You know what's going on.
Is this kind of like the all-time scariest cop?
I don't know. This is my first cop.
What, like ever?
Yeah, I'm not a criminal.
I like how the textures for the tires loaded in as he was pulling the door. That was kind of cool.
Now you folks want to tell me just what in the hell you are doing all the way out here this late at night?
We were just taking in the sights, officer. Is that a crime?
Ma'am. I'm going to take it by the tone of your voice that you were unaware that this is an open season hunting zone until tomorrow.
Oh, shit. No, didn't know that. We were kind of lost, actually.
What is your intended destination?
We're headed up to Hackett's quarry.
Not the camp.
It's a free place to stay, so, yeah.
Yeah, he does have blood on his neck.
You're not going to make it to Hackett's Quarry. Not tonight. Harbinger Motel. It's the nearest place. You can bunk up there for the night, okay?
I think we're just going to stick to the plan, sir. I mean, Mr. Hackett knows we're coming and we called ahead.
No, ma'am. You're going to head to the Harbinger Motel. Do you understand?
With all due respect, sir, why can't we go to Hackett's Quarry?
Because I told you to go to the motel.
Okay, I just don't understand what the problem...
Ma'am, please step out of the vehicle.
Whoa.
What? Why?
Officer, she didn't do anything.
Ma'am, if you wouldn't mind stepping out of the vehicle, I would just like to show you a route on your map there.
Okay. For sure.
Son, remain in the vehicle.
Okay.
Okay. So, we...
Absolutely agree.
All right about here. Harbinger Motel.
I forgot how much the creeps he gave me.
Right.
At the beginning of this game, it's so weird.
Well, I'm sure the fine folks at the Harbinger Motel can guide you there first thing in the morning.
Still, please.
What are you doing?
Hold still.
Well, so, okay, I'm doing a version of the game called Movie Mode, where it's all predetermined outcomes. I don't get to choose what happens. So it's going to be like the one we did tonight is called Gorefest. So it's literally all of the goriest.
Stay on the road.
It's all of the goriest possible options. So it's like whatever will lead. Sorry. Whatever will lead to the most gore, essentially, is what the game is going to pick. So I don't get to choose these options yet, because I've already beat the game on the main playthrough. So I'm going to do another playthrough where I try and let everybody survive. I only lost one person. And then I'm going to do another playthrough where I kill everybody off as fast as possible.
Thanks for all your help, though, back there.
What is that supposed to mean?
You were shaking like a broken washing machine. I could have used a little backup.
I mean, he clearly likes you better.
Well, I'm very likable. All right, let's get back on the road.
Yes.
I think I've had enough woodland encounters for one night. Thank you very much.
Agreed. So where's this motel?
Okay, so we're here.
Mm-hmm.
And the motel is here.
Okay.
But we're going here.
What's there?
This is true.
Quarry.
How'd you do that?
I don't know. I kind of tricked him into showing me.
Very slick. Are you sure we shouldn't just get to the motel and just listen to this guy's advice?
Honey, you really want to listen to the advice of some creep-ass cop who told us in the middle of the creep-ass woods to go to some creep-ass hotel?
No, that sounds terrible.
Yeah.
Let's hit the road, shall we?
That's what I thought.
Ma'am?
Oh my god, if he called me ma'am one more time, I was gonna shove that badge up his dick hole. Seriously, do I look like a ma'am to you? I got like 20 years before I'm a ma'am.
Mm-hmm.
What?
20's debatable.
Easy.
I mean, I'm kinda into ma'ams.
Okay, we're done here.
Yeah. We'll see how this goes down. Yeah, this is like only 20. Okay, to be fair, the prologue and like part one took me a good like 45 minutes to an hour and a half.
There's nobody here. We drive all the way the fuck out
Max,
here.
Max, can we just look around before we jump to conclusions?
Did you actually talk to Mr.
Minutes.
Hackett, or did you just leave a message?
Well, what's the difference?
This is the difference.
Hello?
I guess he doesn't check his voicemail.
How was I supposed to know that? I mean, clearly there's somebody here.
Yeah, or it's just an abandoned car and this is a complete waste
of time. Why would there be an abandoned...
I'll beat the car.
Max, come on.
This is kind of the beginning part that you missed, Fuzzy.
I'm sorry.
Says what doesn't kill you will make you stronger. If you couldn't read that,
what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Oh, okay, I forgot she says it. Never mind. It'd be like that.
Hey, you ready to roll?
No.
I'll be right back. I'm gonna get some help. Max! Max, get over here!
What's going on?
Yeah, they probably do die, to be honest. I have no idea, though.
I think they might be stuck.
Stuck? Is it Mr. Hackett?
I don't know. Just bring some tools so we can break the lock. Hey, I'm back. We're gonna get you out of there.
Hey.
Wait, what are these?
I don't know, you just said tools.
Why didn't you just bring... Look, there's someone in there.
I'm not seeing anyone.
What? No, look.
I'm looking, I am.
Let me see. There was definitely someone there.
Okay, so... You sure?
Yeah, saw it online.
I wonder if it randomizes that choice every single time, because this is what I did last time too, and it worked.
Damn. You need a hand?
Yeah.
Switch to a cutscene.
You've seen The Evil Dead, right?
Hello? Are you hurt?
Do you exist? Hey, be careful.
He says as he goes to sit down on the step. Good job, buddy.
Max?
Maybe it was a possum or something.
No, there was someone here, I swear.
Hey, it definitely is a Dark Souls scene.
It's been kind of a night, you know? Let's just get to the motel. We can come back here first thing in the morning. We can check everything out, but... I mean, you must be exhausted. I know I am. I think our imagination...
Max? Max!
He gone.
What? Help.
I am bleeding a lot.
Yeah, the camp for the werewolves was like a blue sometimes, but it also looked like it had like an eye. I thought he did, but the way like the blood was soaked through his shirt at first, I was very confused. Glad to see I chose the best option for the gore when I first played through.
Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel to you?
Every little movement, every little thing you do.
Oh yeah, I agree. Yeah, no, dogs are definitely the most annoying part of playing Dark Souls games. I absolutely agree there.
Every motion of your hips, I feel the compulsion to pull you to my sweet lips.
Sit up last. He, they talk about it. He shot Chris. I don't want to spoil it. He shot the werewolf. I almost spoiled it. You know who the werewolf is. That's a spoiler, so I'm not going to say anything. Technically, I think Fuzzy also saw who the werewolf was. When Fuzzy was watching last night. But I don't remember. But I don't want to spoil it or anything. Oh, jeez. We're on chapter 1 and that took 30 minutes just for that first part. I want to see how long the movie actually is going to be. I don't know if y'all can even hear me over the music, but I want to see how long this is actually going to end up being. I think it's going to take forever. Oh, yeah, no, you can't see the... Yeah, no, I know you don't know the whole story. But you saw, like, the ending, and it's a part of the ending. They talk about it in the end. But,
Ladies. Boy. Peace and love.
See you later, kids!
Yeah, Hackett's Quarry forever!
Yeah, the whole podcast thing.
You know how many hearts are broken on the last day of summer camp? It's like a romance apocalypse.
Yeah, well, I mean, they're just kids. You know, they'll get over it.
Uh-huh. Like, they'll get over Emma?
What? That's not the same thing.
Oh, so that's not why you're in a bad mood.
I'm not in a bad... Oh, my... You know what? We had our last night together, and we're cool.
Oh, yeah. So cool that you're never gonna see your special little boo-boo bear ever again.
Jesus Christ, you heard that?
Oh, come on, dude. The cabin walls are made of band-aids and rat turds.
Okay, I get it.
All good.
Okay, quit it.
Hi, Emma.
Hey!
Okay, this is, you've heard of spatial awareness before,
yeah.
Right?
Spatial awareness is for nerds. Be a lamb and grab the last couple of bags, will you?
Yes, boss.
Say hi to Emma for me.
You're a bad person.
Yes, I am.
I wonder what's killing the deer.
Interesting. That guy is you.
This is Emma's.
Goodness. Bruh. Man's just yoinked a watch.
Ah, fuck! Ah, fuck you, you spider fuck! Yeah, you better run.
Hey, what are you listening to?
Before they knew it, the whole place was up in smoke.
Good to know. Jesus Christ. Hi. Hey, are you guys gonna help with the bags or what?
Oh, you know, I was actually just working on fixing, the door. It's...
Dylan, come
it's
on.
It's broken.
Dylan, please.
I can't, it's...
I gotta get the last bags
What's
in there, come on.
What's wrong with this thing? It's just
Dylan,
frozen.
Please!
Sorry, bro.
Cool, thanks, guys. Man. Who'd want to leave a place like this? It's like a goddamn Bob Ross. Oh, skill.
They are not both gay. Ugh. One of them is.
Horror. I hate horror.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fair. He definitely was not doing okay last night.
Man, that's a bad place to get stuck.
Good job, buddy.
And this place needs a serious overhaul. Oh. Jesus. Is that you, Dylan?
I can only deal with one shit at a time, Jacob.
Okay, really, dude? Locking me out?
Okay, in my defense, A, it was Dylan's idea, and two, it was really funny.
Oh, yeah, right. Is that right?
I don't write the rules, man.
Okay, whatever. Look, are you gonna help me with the bags or what?
Nah, I gotta stay here and wait for Mr. H to return our cell phone. Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Okay, and why are the stairs blocked?
Well, apparently it's to keep raccoons and other pesky varmints from ransacking the place. Mr. H's words, not mine.
Oh! Boring!
Okay, buddy. Man's wild.
All right. Got the bags.
Great. All by yourself, huh?
Yep.
Guess you're gonna have to get used to that.
Oh my god. You are so mean.
At least I'm honest.
Oh. Dang.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, you're not telling me the whole truth about you and Emma, are you, son?
Okay, I'm gonna need you back all the way out of my business, Caitlin.
Well, excuse me for trying to help.
How is making me feel shitty about being dumped supposed to help?
Aha, the plot thickens. She took out the trash.
What?
Dang.
Wait, check that. First, she cleaned the house.
One second.
Then she took out the trash. Then she washed her hands. Bye-bye, Jake. Now she's a trashless single, clean hands, ready to mingle.
Are you finished?
Oh, I could go all day.
Yeah, no thanks.
Man, you're starting to bum me out, Jake.
Well, I... Yeah, you know, I'm sorry.
Yeah, you're one sorry motherfucker, ain't ya?
Okay, well, at least I went for it this summer.
What's that supposed to mean?
Ryan?
What about him? He's a guy at this camp who just happens to have this whole hot, sexy loner thing that totally doesn't do anything for me at all.
Oh, okay. Plot thickens.
So she really just dumped you just like that?
Well, technically no, but you know, she realized that she has her plans, and I have my plans, and it wasn't going to work after today, you know? And today's already over, isn't it?
And you didn't want to try, like, long distance or whatever? Man, she has got you wrapped all the way around that cute little finger of hers.
No, but I mean, seriously, come on, she's right.
It's just like a stupid summer fling. What else did I think was going to happen?
Let's see. Love, stability, engagement, marriage, house, kid, affair, kid, divorce, loneliness, child support, visitation lawsuit, surprise reconciliation, emptiness, retirement, grandkid, nursing home, and finally, dying in each other's arms and then being buried in each other's arms like those 1,000-year-old skeletons they dug up in Rome or something. That kind of in the ballpark? Oh, shit, I'm sorry. That was Ryan and me. Let me see. Ah, here it is. Yours just says Roadhead. Oh, actually, that's just a generic all-men list.
Well, that seems legit.
Dang. She went off on him, though.
So are we sure that this old rust bucket's roadworthy?
We'll take a look. It better be.
You're actually not wrong there. That is kind of true.
Actually kill me.
Hey, what doesn't kill you will make you stronger.
Well, I haven't killed you yet. You're still pretty pathetic.
Hey, shut up.
Yeah, you're definitely not wrong there.
Okay, so, total hypothetical, but if I was like a huge asshole and I wanted to break down the van so we'd have to spend another night here, what exactly would I need to do?
Well, you'd probably break the fuel line or, I don't know, rip out the rotor arm. And yes, that would make you a total asshole.
Okay, and what does a rotor arm look like again?
It's like an arm that's all rotary. You know, it's under the little black dome with the leads poking out. Jake, you do realize that even if we somehow did get stuck out here, one more night with Emma wouldn't make a difference. Trust me, chick's made up her mind.
Yeah. Sure.
Good job,
buddy.
Guess
we'll just have to find out.
Which one does he pull? Was that the fuel line? Oh no, that's the rotor arm, isn't it? Yeah, that's the rotor arm.
Come on with me, buddy. I'll put you right back tomorrow. No harm, no foul.
Jeez, man.
Up here, my dudes.
Why did they look like they're up to something?
Hey, Jacob.
What? No, dude, please.
That's definitely you.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man.
Boom. Oh. There it is.
Oh, man. Good
stuff. You still want to say that? Freak. You still say it's definitely you?
Ooh, I wish I had some singles.
Freaks. I'm surrounded by freaks. Oh, thank God. I'm gonna get the whole no technology thing, but take me back, world.
You would have thought Mr. H could have, like, charged up our phones, like, a little bit.
Nothing's ever your fault, is it?
You know, you should really just save it for emergencies only. Unless, of course, is being dumped an emergency?
Oh, Ben.
Back off, dipshit.
I'm sorry. Peace and love, man. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Y'all ready to bounce?
Where's everybody else?
Why would I know that?
Sometimes you know stuff I don't.
Look, I don't even know how to respond to that.
You say, Nick, you're way smarter than me, and you're a super hot stud who gets any chick he wants.
Okay, yeah. Keep dreaming, Junior.
Sorry about that. Yeah, no, I don't know if it's the bad choice would be the right one, but that's literally the choice I chose.
Party bear.
Status report.
We are officially empty nesters. High five up top.
Don't miss it.
Oh, too slow.
Really? Oh boy. You're about to get your phone back, aren't you?
Let's go collect our bags and away from this mosquito infested backwoods dump.
Doors locked, bags inside.
Fuck me.
Yep.
Hold on, one second.
It's obvious what we have to do here.
Find someone with a key?
Shape our destiny. And by shape our destiny, I mean shape our way through this crappy lock and grab our bags.
Okay, let's do it. We better not get in trouble.
I won't tell if you won't tell.
Mr. Hackett's gonna find out.
So what? He'll just think it was a bear or something.
Have you ever seen a bear in these woods?
No, but that doesn't mean they're not out there.
Fair point.
All right, let's do this. On three. One, two, three! Ugh. All about the power of positive thinking.
Why do I ever listen to you?
Because I'm always right.
Are you sure they're gonna think it was a bear?
Oh my god, relax. It's not like we killed someone.
All right, well, I'm just gonna take another look around, make sure we didn't miss anything.
Go nuts!
Okay, if y'all can't hear the dogs, I'm gonna keep myself unmuted.
Can't believe I'm actually gonna miss all those lumpy, loose springs. Aw. This was little Izzy's.
I wanna play a game!
Let's get you back to Izzy.
I find that so creepy. Like, the whole fact that it's, like, just a wind-up... or a voice box like that. It's just so weird.
Why would this place be in the news? Hey! You stop that!
She just teleported outside of the cabin, my goodness. That was interesting.
It's gonna be weird not waking up to Dylan's morning announcements.
It did the scary noise again, but I still didn't see anything.
Dylan is not gonna be happy that the kids just left this year.
Oh my goodness, that was loud.
Tell Chris about it when we see him.
Oh, the lady's face in the thing.
Ouch.
I watched the stream again.
Jacob hasn't seen this.
I have Bloodborne. I could play that too.
Ew. What is that?
Yeah, in the window for a split second, very, very, very small second, you could see the old lady's face, like, in the window. The creepy dead old lady.
I don't think anyone knocked Caitlin out of first place all summer.
Ready to roll?
Let's do it.
Finally! Time to let
that radio was very loud.
How are you so
dramatic?
Annoying. Confident.
It's just acting. It's what the people want.
So you're faking it?
I mean, in a way, faking it is just being yourself, but louder. You should try it sometime. You never know who you might impress.
Nah. It's too late now anyway.
For what? You and Nick? You never know unless you put yourself out there.
R.I.P. the pothole.
Eyes on the road, lady.
Sorry. Okay, so, hypothetically, if I were to put myself out there, what if he ends up being a dud?
Yeah, sounds about
like
right.
You and Jacob.
Marika.
He's actually really sweet.
Then why'd you quit it?
Summer fling. We're going to school, like, four states away. He gets it.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
But, that's us. You and Nick could be different. Why don't you get his handle? Hit him up.
Oh, I already have his email. It was in the packet they gave to us on the first day.
Email? Are you 93?
What's wrong with email?
I'm really gonna miss you, Abby.
Oh, hold up!
Oh, but the lodge is that way.
Go right here.
Why?
Come on, scenic route? One last victory lap around the camp?
We should really get back.
Boo. Thumbs down.
Everyone's waiting for us.
Nick isn't gonna leave without saying goodbye.
Shit, Abby!
Oh, don't tell me they... No! R.I.P. Ran over the squirrel.
Oh, Emma. It's still alive.
That does not look good.
What do I do?
First blood. Yeah, sounds about right. We had the one bro, Max, got mauled in the beginning, but that happened last time too.
Abby, it's suffering.
Does she do it? I don't know what that was, but I guess she does it. R.I.P. squirrel dude. Oh, does it show it? Yikes. Oh, no. R.I.P. the squirrel. It showed the splat and everything. Oh, man. That's unfortunate. Well, we've got, like you said, first blood. It definitely
Don't
started.
Don't worry, Jacob. I got you. I got Sheesh. A full tank of gas.
So. My goodness.
Oh, fuck me.
First death was the squirrel.
Oh, idiot.
Does nobody own phone chargers anymore?
There's no signal out here anyways, dude, okay? This place is like patchy as balls.
Your balls are patchy?
What? No.
It's okay. I'll just go get some juice from Mr. H before we go.
Ew. Hey, Nick.
Hey, where were you guys?
Wouldn't you like to know? Ignore her, please.
Let's go.
Just gotta get these bags up onto the...
Oh, hey, here. Let me get it for you.
I can take care of my own bag, thank you.
Are you sure? Because, I mean, it's really not that big of a deal.
She can take care of her own bag, thank you.
We can both take care of our own bag, thank you.
Dang.
Cool.
Abby, do you need...
Yeah.
Can I...
Thank you.
Like, so she just chucks it on the ground instead of, like, handing it to him or anything? He was, like, a couple inches away from, like, having it near his hand.
Hey, has anyone seen Ryan?
Oh, yeah, he's probably off being all brooding and mysterious and alluring somewhere.
I'm here.
What were you doing under there? Having a little knee party?
I was listening to a podcast, actually.
Oh, podcast. Nice, that's cool.
What's it about?
Yeah, what's it about? Is it about me?
You think I was listening to a podcast about you?
Okay, if anyone here had a podcast about them, it'd be me.
Yeah, if there was a podcast called How to Look and Smell Like a Butt.
Oh my god, you are so childish.
Really,
so
don't look and smell like a butt.
No, it's a paranormal podcast. This episode was actually about this place, weirdly enough. The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
The who of the what's it where now? What's the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
You don't know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
If I did, would I be asking them ass?
Dang.
Tell her about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I don't think she wants to know about the Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Can we just please stop saying the Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
It's just this campfire story for the kids. It's, there's supposedly an old woman who died in a fire a few years back. She haunts the woods looking for her lost baby boy. There are, like, reports of whispers or whatever, and this figure that
tutorial boss. Yeah, that was
some people say that if she catches you alone, she'll try to turn you into her son.
Goodness.
Or kill you. Or something. I don't know. It's never really been clear. Anyways, Haga Haggett's Corey.
You made that up.
Right here in the podcast, man.
Cool story, yeah. Bro.
Just listen to the podcast, buddy.
Seriously, though, you should have seen the first time he told the story to the kids at the campfire. They were scarred for life.
I mean, not for life.
You gotta be careful with this stuff, man. This shit's true.
Come on, dude, bullshit.
What's the holdup, Hacketeers?
Nearly done, Mr. H.
Well, hop to it. Get those butts in gear.
He's also super creepy.
H. Yeah, deliberate some luggage.
Shut up.
Maybe if somebody didn't spend so much time trying to impress the ladies with all his ghost stories.
You asked.
Ghost stories?
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
Oh!
Gonna miss Squirrel, dude.
Hey, you still have the van key, Mr. H?
Well, yes, I do. You know, I'd lose my head if it wasn't stuck on. Back to the office I go. Give me a hand, would you, Ryan?
Oh, okay.
Yo, Mr. H.
What's up, DJ Dylan?
Any chance I could get a little charge? I want to have some tunes for the road.
No can do.
Cool, yeah. No worries.
Good man.
No big deal. You can share my earbuds.
Exactly. Maruka gets it. Am I saying that wrong?
So, Chris, I'm actually glad we got a moment to talk.
I'm not fired, am I?
No, it's just, you know, about the whole thing with the...
Hold that thought, partner. I'm gonna have to take this.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Sorry.
Yeah, the keyword there is was.
Hello?
R.I.P. Low man gone. goodness. Listen in.
What? Because kids are kids. Don't only be so much your bone.
They're almost out of here, all right?
You're cutting it pretty close. We don't want to have...
Just hold your damn horses, all right? Everything's A-OK on this end.
Bobby and I are geared up. If he's in the area, we'll get him.
This is a waste of time.
You know what? I know it.
No, should I have?
He's gone quiet.
Probably staying out of the way. Speaking of which, the longer you keep me on this damn phone, the longer it's gonna take me to get rid of these damn kids.
Yeah.
Of course. Adios.
Yeah, he was definitely just standing there awkwardly.
Sorry, I wasn't listening. I was just, like, waiting. Like, I mean, I heard... I didn't hear what you were...
We're cool, champ. Just come on in. Sorry I pushed you out like that.
Dude, so awkward in literally everything.
You need a hand looking for the keys?
No. End of summer. Busy. You know. Anyway, you were asking me?
Oh, yeah. It was just the whole animation school thing, what you thought I should do.
Right.
You know... whether or not I should, like, leave my sister with my grandparents, since I'd have to live on campus, you know, and my mom's not exactly around, so I wouldn't want to leave Sarah on her own. You know, our family's small enough as it is.
Family is important, Ryan.
It's all about family.
Dang it.
He's literally Vin Diesel.
Is everything okay? You got a hot date tonight?
Oh boy. If you only knew.
So,
well, you're not wrong there.
What did you need me for?
You're one of my favorite counselors, Ryan. You know that. One of the good ones. But do you know how many calls I get from parents, letter after letter, with these terrified kids that they send home?
Huh. I didn't realize that.
Believe it or not, scaring kids away from sleepaway camp is kind of bad for business. So maybe just ease up on the ghost stories.
You'll have to wait to find out.
I didn't realize it was such a big deal.
Gotta understand the repercussions of your actions, Buster.
Just never reading your comment again.
It's a big part of being a counselor, a leader.
Yeah.
Just stick to kumbaya next time, okay?
What's that?
You guys don't do kumbaya anymore? Good grief. I'm outgrowing my own cliches.
Seriously, Chris, what's going on?
I just want to get you guys safely out of Dodge before the sun goes down.
Why are you trying to get us out safe, huh? What's going on here, buddy?
Yeah.
Best to get you all out of harm's way. Woods are chock full of live game and local hunters hop to it the second camp's over. It's not safe.
They say they literally haven't seen anything all summer.
Good goddamn, are they?
Will you say goodbye to Caleb and Kaylee for me? They sort of just snuck off.
Well, you'll see him again next year. Caleb works at the scrapyard during the off-season, and Kaylee, well, she's still figuring out what she wants to do. She's got her whole life ahead of her. They both just come and go as they please, really. Teenagers, am I right?
Actually, could have used the help packing up since we were short-staffed.
Hey, you guys seem to manage, all right? This
definitely isn't helping.
But I'll tell them both you were sad you missed them. Unlocked the van, put the keys in my pocket, came in the office. Right where I left them. Let's skedaddle.
Yeah, Ryan's like the most awkward person in the entire game. His scenes kind of like bother me, to be honest with you.
Make sure they're all ready to go. For real this time.
Wait, how did you get your phone back before the rest of us?
I never turned it in.
You shouldn't have turned it off before you handed it in, Dylan. Them's the rules, you noob.
Hey, he got told.
I try not to dwell on the past, man.
Good. Because it's time to dwell in the minivan. Get on with our respective lives. Move it, let's go. What's the problem?
Ugh. Dude, I don't know. I think there's something wrong with the engine, Mr. H.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah, dude, it's just like... kaput.
All right, let me try.
What, dude, I'm telling you, all right, it's busted.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
Well, maybe you're doing it wrong.
The fuck, dude?
Enough. Enough, both of you. Shit. Come on.
All right,
come
dude, on. Chill. Chill, dude.
Good job, Jacob.
Damn it. I thought I told you kids to check everything.
We did. It should be working.
Yeah, well... coulda and shoulda doesn't mean it is, does it? Damn it!
He got so mad.
Okay. Okay.
Look, it's not that big of a deal, okay? We'll just spend one more night here.
No! No! Just stop. Let me think.
Someone's a little angry.
Damn it. You're right, yeah.
What?
Yeah, you're right.
Wait, why did it pause like that? I thought he dropped them.
Hey, Brian. Come here for a sec.
Yeah, you're not wrong there. She really did. She didn't say anything about it.
Make sure that everybody is inside the lodge for tonight. Lock the doors. No one in, no one out. No one. Got it?
Okay.
I'll be back first thing in the morning. And we'll get you all on the
road.
Yeah,
she isn't. You just have to she keep didn't help anything inside. At all. She just.
You promise me you'll do that.
Literally explained.
Yeah. Sure. We'll stay inside.
Sorry, I don't want to talk too much over there. She literally told him how to.
For God's sake, keep the noise down!
She literally told him how to take out the rotor arm, too. Like, at the beginning.
So, what was that about?
He, said to stay inside, that we're not leaving until the morning.
Are you kidding me?
Am.
Are you kidding me? What are we supposed to do?
Well, we should go inside, like he said.
We could go inside until morning.
Yeah.
Or we could do something else.
No. We should really listen to what Chris told us to do.
Of course.
Who cares what Chris told us to do? He's not our boss anymore. P-A-R-T. Why the fuck not? All right, it seems like the stars have aligned for us, no?
Okay.
One last epic bonfire blowout for all time.
Oh, dude. Fuck yes, I'm in. Nick, you're in.
Yeah, I'm in.
Dylan's
in. I didn't really give him a choice.
My man. Caitlin?
I go where my people need me.
Yeah, okay. Em, what do you say?
Yeah, I'm in. Mr. Hackett seemed pretty insistent we stay in the lodge.
He was just trying to freak us out, you know? Like one of Ryan's stupid ghost stories.
Why would he want to scare us?
I'm sure he's just looking out for us. No big deal.
Well, fair enough there.
All right, yeah.
No,
party.
I didn't mean...
Dang.
High five. Touch my hand, Ryan.
Fine.
Yes.
Yes.
I just want to go on record and say that this is a bad idea.
God, dude.
I like how they're all messing with
them. It's gonna be fine, man. Trust me. It's gonna be chill.
All right. Hacketeers. Party planning committee. Let's do this. Okay. First things first. Nick and Abby, you go get some firewood. Em and I will go to the stores for some supplies. And Dylan, you just, I don't know, figure out how to charge the phones for something. All right, let's do this.
I think we're getting on to chapter 2 now, soon. Oh, that's right. Yeah, we're only on chapter 2 and it's been an hour and 10 minutes. This is insane. There's still like 8.
So here we are, stranded in the great American wild with nothing but our wits to guide us. Will humanity prevail, or will we grow ravenous and resort to eating the flesh of the deceased like I saw in that one plane crash movie? First course, filet au Jacob. Rich and full-bodied, this rare beefcake may leave an irritating taste lingering on the palate. An acquired taste, some would say. Wow.
What?
Looks like you're trying to thread a needle with a packet of loose sausages.
Oh my god, I'm almost done, okay?
Yeah, for real. Jesus. You're not wrong there, Marika.
And for the record, your analogies are very hurtful. Okay, I'm almost there. 1 second.
There we go! And Viola, your hair clip, madame.
Yeah, you can keep it.
It's not too shabby, huh?
Yeah. I like a man who's good with his hands.
Yeah, well, they call me Mr. Magic Fingers.
Okay, no. Buddy. Dang. Okay.
So, if I were a beer...
Getting called out better, huh?
Where would I be hiding? Beep, 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 beep. Beep,
what
beep,
are you doing?
Beep. Oh, it's my beer dar. Helps me dar for beers.
Huh. How am I just noticing how super lame you are?
What? But it's my beer dar, dude.
I'm gonna go over here. Wow, the kids really wiped this place out. Mr. H loved his accessories. Think it's locked. Don't know what I was expecting.
Oh, hell yeah! Oh, jackpot! Hey,
check out my giant melons.
See, you just cut a hole in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's awesome, your vodka. America.
It's party time.
You pour the vodka right in it.
Yeah, it's the most fun you could have with a hole in a watermelon.
You must have missed that part. He talked about being able to pick the lock, and he said they do call me was it Magic Fingers or something like that? Say I have magic fingers, something like that.
Harem scarum. Why is this crap? Friends.
How did I miss that when I was running through there?
Can't pass up an opportunity like this. Okay, have y'all ever seen a grown man crap his pants? Because you're about to.
Oh goodness, we're gonna scare Jacob. Yeah, that's a great idea.
Oh my. All right, now where should I hide? Jacob!
Emma?
Oh my goodness, hello? Why are we doing this?
Look, if you're trying to scare me, it's not gonna work.
Now that I know this is an option, I'm going to do this next time.
Ah! You're not scared of clowns?
What? No, they're funny.
You think this is supposed to be funny?
I mean, yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Do you think it's funny now, little boy?
Because
you want to join 20 of my sexy clone friends in a tiny car that somehow fits us all like it's no big deal?
Yeah. What?
Moment's gone.
Not forgotten.
Wonder where this goes. Locked. Jacob! Come check this out.
Alrighty then. Door, buckle up because you are about to meet your maker. Done.
Nice.
Yes.
Whoa.
The fucking mother load.
Good golly, Miss Molly. No wonder he kept this place locked up.
Think he'll be pissed when we raid his stash?
What? No. I mean, he left us stranded here. It's like, human rights, or whatever.
Sure, yeah.
All right. Now let's see what we are working with. Hold that. The door will latch otherwise. Oh. Hell yeah. In and out. Job done. Boom.
I want to look around.
Go for it.
Yeah, there definitely is.
Jacob, check this out.
What? See, that's called watching for the plot.
They look like camping supplies.
Goodness.
Okay.
Okay. One thing I want to do really quick.
There's tents back at the fire pits.
I can. I was gonna say. I wonder if it shows me all of the evidence that they found and the clues and everything. That's kind of funny. Does it include the stuff that I already know? Hold on. Oh, it doesn't. Oh, shoot. Okay. Well, already.
Let's go.
Oh, we'll have to look at that at the very end.
Did a bear do this?
That we can see.
Oh, cool.
What? What is it?
A gun.
Oh, cool.
I like how the reaction is, oh, cool, and nothing else. She seems a little too excited about the gun. No spoilers. Wow. Okay.
Okay. I'm done.
Well, no. I didn't think it was gonna show me stuff from my old saves, but I wanted to see if it would show everything that I found so far, which is kind of cool. Gun,
huh? Yeah. For bears.
Okay. Well, I am gonna find something to haul this lot back to camp. All right.
She definitely takes the fireworks.
I'm in.
Hey, very nice. What else is in there?
Just some fireworks.
Oh, fireworks?
Yeah, but I don't think we should.
No, Emma. Fireworks.
You know, you're right.
Why did it?
Fireworks.
It's done that twice now where it blacks it out
fireworks.
For a second.
Oh, and might I just add, fireworks.
Hey, I found these, torn up bags back there. They were pretty messed up, and I think they might have had blood on them.
Oh, stop. Stop. Stay right there. Oh, dude. Peanut butter butter pops. Dude, peanut butter fucking butter pops.
What are butter pops?
No.
What?
I can't believe it. Okay. Pop, pop, peanut butter pops. Pop, pop, pop them in your mouth. Pop. Oh my God, they're like the greatest snack of all time.
What are they? Are they like popcorn?
What? No. They're nothing like popcorn.
He really
they're
is like actually their own though. Thing.
Like their own.
Yeah, he's very dismissive and
food snack. You know what? I haven't had these since I was a kid. You are in for such a treat.
Okay, wait. Is there an expiration date on that bag?
No, they're still good.
Oh my God, they're like 20.
The way
years
her
older.
Mouth okay. moved right Look, there was so weird when she said that.
Well, you're gonna love them. Well, I saw a wheelbarrow out front, so we can load up all our booty in there.
I'm sorry, what?
Booty? Oh, it means like treasure or buds.
No, before that.
Wheelbarrow?
Yeah.
Okay. It's like a barrel with wheels. You can put stuff in it and just wheel it around.
Oh,
yeah, good job, Jacob.
I see.
Very smart there, buddy. I don't think anybody could have explained that any better.
First.
What a dumb nuts. I swear. He's like his whole thing bothers me so much. His whole line, like everything that he says just bothers me, not gonna lie. I can't do it anymore.
All right.
You're telling me you don't eat anything that's expired?
This is where the magic happens.
Yeah, barrel of wheels. Yeah, for real.
Sure. Just give me a sec to get this going. And
there's definitely no way that she knew that herself.
Podcasts.
Yeah.
All right. What's it called, the one that you're listening to right now?
Bizarre yet bonafide.
Oh yeah, no, I despise him.
So like ghosts and stuff.
I absolutely despise him too. Yeah, I can't blame you there.
Yeah, like the weird and the wonderful, digging up weird mysteries and discussing if they're, well, bonafide.
Boner fide.
Ha ha.
Get it.
Boner. Good job, buddy. Super proud of you for that one, Dylan.
No bounds.
Should we check out what Mr. H keeps in his private den of sin?
I don't know, man. I feel talking about weird Linda. Going through his stuff.
Okay, well, I don't. I mean, come on, what kind of dirty secrets is the owner of a summer camp full of impressionable young children going to have anyway? Not Mr. H, I know. He's cool.
It's always been
Was
cool
there
to
something
me.
Else in the background? Or?
Whoa, look at this old thing. Hey, give me your number. I want to try it out.
Why?
So that I can ask you out on a date.
Smooth.
I think if I tried a cell phone number on this thing, it would just explode. Hello? What?
What? Who is it?
Hello? It's weird. I thought I heard someone.
Maybe you should have asked them out on a date.
Damn it, I missed my shot. Kaylee and Caleb Hackett. Weird kids, huh?
I like them.
Yeah, me too. They are pretty reclusive, you have to admit. Well, hello, what is this? You hear that?
Is that a trap door?
I knew that there was a secret sex dungeon around here somewhere.
Yeah.
I bet you Mr. H is into some real kinky shit.
I doubt it.
Weren't there a couple counselors who never showed up?
Why?
Secret sex dungeon.
Yeah, it's not funny. It probably just goes to the basement or something. Open it up.
Well, if you insist, Ryan.
All right, well, it looks like a pit of eternal darkness, so
You're being dramatic.
Climb down. Take a look. Look, you can squeeze through there.
You opened it. You climb down.
Yeah, she definitely is.
On second thought, I'd rather not know what Mr. H is into. It's more mysterious that way.
Sure.
Ooh, that's a nice chair. I could get used to this.
You better hope Mr. H doesn't catch you taking his baby out for a joyride.
Ringy-dingy-ding. Oh, sorry, bud. Gotta take this one second. Hello, Hackett's Quarry Summer Camp. What doesn't kill you will make you stronger. What can I do for you on this darn tootin' doozy of a day?
Is that your impression of Mr. H?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. He does need to be nicer to Dylan. And, what's that? You want him to give Dylan his phone number? That's a little forward, but I can see what I can do.
Smooth.
Whoa. What you find in there, buddy?
Oh. Laura Kearney and Max Brindley.
Oh, yeah, those are the ones that never showed up.
Yeah, it's because of these goobers that we had to work extra shifts this summer.
Whoa. But you have no idea what happened to them now, do you, buddy? How do you know nothing bad happened, huh?
Hey, what's the gun for?
Chris... Mr. H told me it was for, bears.
Bears? Here?
Yeah, he said they don't really come around because he's got the gun to...
Yeah, for real. No, you're not wrong there. I absolutely agree, that is very obvious.
Leave it alone.
Dude, we're gonna be out partying in the woods tonight, alright? What if the bears try to crash? Okay, it's like my mom always said, if you want to party, you gotta bring protection.
Well, I think that she was talking about condoms.
I'm not gonna fuck a bear.
The most dangerous thing I've seen in these woods is a pissed off squirrel.
That sounds pretty scary. Okay, fine.
Density of a brick wall. Absolutely
well,
true.
We know where the gun is, if we need it.
Your call, man.
We're an hour and a half in, and we're almost to chapter 2. I may not be doing movie
toss
tonight, because,
So you can poke around in Chris's private area?
I'm sorry, is that something that only you're allowed to do?
Hardy har har.
Come on, what's the harm in looking? You're not a little bit curious? I'm not going to touch anything.
Fine. Don't let me regret it.
Can't promise that, but... Nothing but net.
You're using that wrong.
Oh. Huh.
Oh, goodness.
Fashion icon.
Mr. H knows what he likes.
Sure he does.
This is why chapter 1 took me so long.
Yo.
Hey, maybe we shouldn't...
Ryan?
Whoa, what the fuck?
These monitors, this is the camp.
Huh.
Is Mr. H spying on us?
No. I mean, no, he can't be. These are just... They're all different trails in the woods around camp.
A few hours?
Sure.
Definitely a little over.
Most of the cameras are pointed away from camp, so it's not like he's spying on the kids. Unless they wandered out into the woods. You know, these are just... Probably just trail cameras.
What are trail cameras?
People set them up to catch weird, random shit.
Okay, yeah, like what?
Like Bigfoot sightings, you know, that kind of thing.
You're not wrong.
That
is true. I didn't even realize
that.
Maybe he likes throwing up the keys.
Secret hobby, I guess.
Expensive hobby.
That is very true.
Yeah.
Like,
what else are you gonna do out here?
Yeah, I guess camp probably does get pretty lonely when there's no one else around.
Yeah.
Okay, but why go through all the trouble of hiding this room through a secret door in the closet?
I mean, it's not exactly secret, right? Like, it's just hidden by stuff.
Yeah, that's what a secret is, Ryan. It's weird. It's majorly weird.
I don't disagree with you, but
yeah,
it's gotta
though.
Be
that's
something
literally
juicy
how it's been the whole game so far.
It's none of our business. And if you really want to know, you can
times.
Ask him tomorrow.
It probably
so
it, happen. It does happen quite often.
At all.
I don't know. Maybe not.
Okay,
dozen,
yeah, maybe I will.
But not wrong there either.
All right. I'm leaving this secret lair. Have fun.
Hey, you just admitted that it's a secret lair. What was that?
Oh, there's the old man.
It's probably nothing.
I like how he says it's probably nothing when he very clearly sees that it's a person.
Nice. Full up. Hey, Dunzo.
Alright, cool. Let's go.
Thank you.
The story's moving along a lot faster than whenever I played it, to be honest. However, it's still very funny. Well, we'll have to find out now, won't we, Maruko?
It's really very pretty out here when there's no kids around.
Yeah, they can get kind of obnoxious, huh?
Yeah.
They always seem to listen to you during painting class.
You've seen my class?
Just walking by.
The art cabin's
okay,
all the way
buddy.
Out of the way.
Yeah, well, there's this shortcut that I take that goes by. Which way should we go?
Why don't you choose?
Let's go to the rocky path. I hate that it does that. It like cuts it down. And I think it's because I'm on a
PS4.
Better
sticks this way.
Better sticks?
Yeah. Like burning or whatever.
That's what she said.
Think we've got enough?
Not yet.
That room
so this place
FNAF.
Was an actual quarry?
Yeah.
Apparently some of the caves run pretty deep.
Understand.
It's like a honeycomb under there.
Cool.
Abby, wildin', bro.
Are you sure this is safe?
Yeah, watch out, numbnuts.
What, are you scared?
No. Are you?
No.
I'm calling right now that a rock falls down and splats them.
Shit.
It's all right. Calm down.
So, you ever think about what's next?
Like, after we die? It's heavy, man.
No, I mean, like, the future.
Yeah, sometimes. All the time. It's overwhelming.
I know what you mean. Sometimes I just try to, like,
cue.
Let it happen, you know?
Huh?
Like, whatever happens is what was meant to happen.
Like, it's all predetermined. Fate.
I don't know. I'm not sure we're supposed to know.
Yeah, Fate just seems so convenient.
How so?
Because if it's all predetermined and you do something terrible, then you have the excuse of saying, well, it wasn't really me because everything's been pre-planned and then I'm not really in control of my actions, am I?
I never really thought about it like that before.
I mean, well, it's, yeah, it's totally
not wrong
okay
there whatsoever.
If you believe that.
Yeah, no, totally.
Yeah.
Good job, Abby. Nice save.
I know where we are.
Yeah?
Up here. Here, hold these.
Sure.
This view is just...
Wow. So all roads lead to the same ending here. Interesting. This is what it was last time I played too.
Damn, Abby, you're really good.
No, this is nothing.
No, really, I'm not just saying that.
This is rough, but if I can get a little bit of it down, then I'll remember it better later.
We don't get to any, like, really gore cool until, like, yourself. The next chapter.
Yeah. I guess so.
Or the chapter after, I believe.
Not everyone knows what they're capable of, you know?
I'm sure you're capable of a lot, Nick.
I mean, of course. I just... don't know what.
You'll figure it out.
Aww. We should. Hey, Nick and Abby...
Did you hear that?
It's probably nothing.
No, listen. There's something there.
Ah, what could it be? Tis a baby boar.
It's so tiny.
Oh my goodness. Better watch out.
My god, he's so cute.
That's fair. Can't blame me there.
The slime!
Mans didn't hold his breath long enough. He's gonna... he didn't get killed, at least.
Oh, no.
Or get hurt. It's just... funky.
Okay.
That was interesting.
Did you get all that?
Huh?
I thought you were gonna draw me getting Frenched by a wild pig.
Ah. Got it all up here.
There's no escape. So I'll grab my keys.
Honestly understandable why you would think that he would get an arrow to the head.
Guess we should head back.
It did say hunting season after all. Okay. If y'all want to give me 1 second, I had laundry going and I didn't even think about it. So I'm going to leave it going because obviously it's a movie and it's going to keep going by itself. But I myself will be right back. I'm still going to have my phone on, so I should be able to see all the comments. But un momento, por favor. I'll be right back.
finally get my phone back, and it's just a big dumb brick.
Hey, Caitlin. Guess what? Mr. H is a voyeuristic creep. He has hidden cameras everywhere and a secret room.
No, that's not...
Whoa, now, back up. What?
His eyes are everywhere. He's always watching us.
Fuck it off, man. He's just got trail cameras set up, you know, forest surveillance, that kind of thing.
Oh.
You don't think that's weird?
Well, he's got a perimeter to check, kids to protect. You know, probably just to keep track of wildlife.
You guys have no imagination.
So, what's going on here? Everything ready?
I did see a weird light in the treehouse across the lake. Yeah, that was pretty spooky. Maybe it's your girlfriend, Ryan.
The Hag of Hackett's Quarry.
I told you never to say Hag of Hackett's Quarry again.
What's wrong with saying Hag of Hackett's Quarry?
Are you done? You know, I just realized we may never see each other again after tonight.
You can't have just realized that.
Just trying to set the mood.
What mood?
The mood, the vibe, you know.
Speaking of setting the mood, I have work to do. Okay, because playlists don't make themselves. I mean, I guess they do, but...
All right, Rad Guy, time to get wood.
Yikes, wording.
Oh, I know what I said. Abby, Nick, just in time. We got wood. We've already done that joke.
It's mostly just kindling.
Oh, that's all we need. There's already a big pile of logs here.
We could have gotten more, but there was a hog or a boar. But Nick was very, very brave and took one for the team.
Are you sure you guys are okay? Nobody got gored?
We're okay.
It wasn't a bullfight or anything.
Though I think Nick did make a new girlfriend.
Oh, do tell.
Special delivery.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Where the hell did that gun come from?
Dude, relax, okay? It's not even real.
Well,
I mean, it's a real gun, but it's just for shooting bears.
We found it in the storage room.
Okay, fine. Fine, we'll put it down.
Thank you. Guns are no joke, dipshit.
And... We bring you a hand-picked selection of only the finest that Hackett's Quarry has to offer.
No freaking way.
Yes, freaking way. Pop, pop, peanut butter, butter pops. Pop, pop, pop them in your mouth. Pop!
I didn't even know you could still find these anywhere.
Hey, hey, hey. Cool your jets there, cowboy. All right, these are spoken for.
Dude, you can't just shove those in my face and not expect me to want to pop them in my mouth.
Sorry about that, y'all. I am now officially back.
Please hand me a shotgun.
But you're not wrong.
Shoot me over them?
No, dumbass. Okay, we are going to shoot for them.
Nearly missed the gore.
Nah, dude. Absolutely not. No.
Okay, as much as I enjoy watching Nick squirm away from a talent, I don't think this
well,
is a great idea.
Hey.
I appreciate
you know
it.
What? Yeah. You're right. Maybe I should just give Nick the butter pops as like an act of charity or something.
Fine, you're on.
Yeah, boy!
Jacob, hand me that gun now.
Dang, why do you keep calling people
like
weeds?
Any firearm, you're gonna act like a dick about it.
Listen, you can be the ref. We need an objective third party.
Okay, we're trying to get a party started here, Jacob.
Okay, well, the main party's
just
not gonna die
joking.
Just because you're off on a little side quest. Come on! Please.
All right. Guess we're gonna have ourselves an old-fashioned shootout. Look, there's a clearing we can use as a shooting range back there, but... If I see either of you dicking around, I am turning this car around.
Oh,
we'll be good.
Okay, so, just so you know, I was an expert marksman. Third class, 3 years in a row, ranked high. Third class... 3 years in a row, ranked highest in camp each year. I'm just letting you know that your goose is cooked, Nick, but if you back down now, I might let you just have one little peanut butter butter pop if you're lucky.
No way. You've never even seen me shoot.
Yeah, that's because you've never shot before.
Yeah, not that you know of.
Okay, I think I would know if
you'd
actually...
Okay, boys, I'm going to have to stop you right there. As much as I'm enjoying your charming machismo, the moment we step foot on the shooting range, we're playing by my rules, okay? And what I say goes. Got it? Okay, good. Now I'm going to go set up some targets and get more shells. Do not move a muscle or touch his gun until I'm back.
All right, so is it just me or is it kind of hot when she gets all bossy like that?
I'm always hot, pencil
down. Yeah, okay, thank you. Bye. Bye.
Goodness.
So, how was your little one-on-one with Abby in the woods?
It was okay.
Hey, attaboy! So, I mean, what happened?
Well, we flirted a little. She's really smart.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I've never had.
I mean, you
goose,
see the deal?
So
don't
I.
What did
I look? No sweat. Okay. We all get performance anxiety sometimes. You just better make your move before a real man swoops in. Speaking of, let me show you how a real man shoots his gun.
Are you guys seriously still thumping your chests at each other?
No, I think he's got brain damage.
Okay, please just give me the gun.
You'll have it when I say you'll have it. All right, huddle up, boys. This is how we're gonna do this. You're shooting the one on the left. Nick first, then Jacob's turn. Keep your fingers off the trigger till you're ready to shoot. You got it?
Aye, aye.
All right. Two things. Remember the spread, remember the recoil. This is a shotgun. We're not sharpshooting here. The flashlight shows you where you're aiming. Obvs.
You got this, Nick.
All right, Nick, 1 point.
Ah, what a legend.
Okay, we're too far back to do any real damage. Let's scooch forward a little and fuck these guys up. You're good. All right, Nick, this time for real.
Come on, Nick. Dude, really?
Nice shot.
Dang.
Lucky.
Look at him. Oh, goodness.
Point to you, Nick. Good job,
Get
Nick.
Get pranked, buddy.
Right. Let's see what you got.
I don't trust you with a shotgun.
All right. You might want to, avert your eyes, Nick. I don't want to give you any more performance anxiety.
All right. Just shut up and shoot, Jacob.
Yeah, show me how it's done, buddy.
Oh, I thought you were an ultra-elite pro marksman.
Yeah, with, like, a rifle.
Whoa,
okay,
dude,
not with this freaking cannon
cool.
blaster.
That is how you get someone shot.
Nah, it's okay. You probably would have missed me anyway.
Hey!
Disqualified for being a dumbass.
What? No!
Get wrecked, nerd.
Sorry, Jacob. Better luck next time.
Better luck next time?
Hey, I didn't want to say it, but...
You're both very mean.
Dang, get wrecked, buddy. Let's see, Kaelin's gonna go absolutely off, and this is where, like,
Blaine,
broke my game last time.
What the? Whoa.
Yeah, it's so broken.
Pop, peanut butter, butter pops.
Oh, my goodness. There is no patch since I started playing this game, and it's still broke, where they just appear broken, and it just pops. That's cool. Apparently, I just need to buy a PS5. No. I'm using the PlayStation 4. I cannot afford a PlayStation 5. As much as I wish
okay.
I could.
New idea. Party game. Come on, people. We might never see each other after tonight. Let's make some memories.
Well, what do you have in mind?
How about the ultimate game of secrets and lies?
Yeah,
truth or dare?
Yeah. It's, but also, PS5s, I've never been able to find one, even
okay.
if I did.
House rules are.
Trying has to be able to find one.
Then you choose, and then
one,
you
one, like I said, I can't
and
afford
there's
it.
There's no
but
ifs, ands,
two,
or buts.
So, like, normal truth or dare?
It's impossible to find
yes.
still, somehow.
So we can, like, make people kiss?
If they choose dare, yeah. As long as everyone consents,
of course. Yeah, let's see how this cool goes. Beans.
I mean, keep it in your pants until it's your turn, but...
Well, who does get to go first?
Well, it's house deals, so... Abigail. Truth or dare?
Truth.
Really dodged a bullet, huh? Alright, here goes. Have you ever slept with anyone?
Oh, I...
Ha. I like to be there.
Have you ever slept with anyone at this camp?
No. Nope. Sorry.
All right, Abby, it's your turn.
There's some... Huh. Interesting. Yeah, we don't...
Okay.
I can't find any around here. I have to order online. There's none
Abby,
in
oh my
stores
God,
around
pick
here.
Someone. Okay. I don't know. Ugh. Ding. Too late. My turn.
Stop trying to talk too much over them.
Truth or dare?
Dare. Give me what you got.
Okay, Ryan. Your dare comes with a choice.
Can't you do that?
I can do whatever I want. And I dare you to kiss either Caitlin or Dylan.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
I mean, I guess both is off the table.
Sorry. I don't make the rules.
And you literally just did, but okay. Let's do this.
What?
Caitlin, shall we?
Dang. Rip Dylan. This wasn't...
Always happy to please.
This didn't happen last time. rip.
Alrighty, who shall I pick?
Well, me and Jacob haven't gotten a turn yet.
Good point. Alright, Jacob, let's see what you're made of.
Oh, there, man, come on.
Oh, my goodness. Of course.
I dare you to take a flying leap over that fire pit. Naked.
Oh, dude!
Oh,
fuck
no.
Yes. Oh, I will jump over this thing. I don't care.
Oh,
yeah,
no.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Does
no,
this...
Jacob. Wait. Don't do it. Stop. Dude, I say veto. You're gonna fuck yourself up.
What? No, come on, man. I got this.
Ryan, come on.
Fine, veto.
You know what? Fuck this game. All right? Someone else can go.
Okay, fine. Then I call your turn.
Whatever.
Jeez. My goodness.
There. Emma, so you have to kiss... Jacob? Or...
Oh.
Nick. Well, then...
Sorry, Nick. This is not even there, obviously.
I don't know if that's a good idea.
Let's see.
I choose Nick.
Oh. R.I.P. him and Abby.
What? M? Seriously?
Guys.
Feels bad.
Guys!
Thank you, Nick. He's good.
You like kissing my girlfriend, asshole?
It was just a game.
Hey, I'm nobody's girlfriend.
The fuck it was. It was just a game. Yeah, the fuck it was, man.
Understandable.
Jacob, grow up.
Can't blame you there.
Well, I guess I should probably.
That's probably the most, him. Like.
You should probably go find Abby.
Non-PG, like, 13. That's, like, the closest to being non-PG 13 it gets.
Anybody want to play Parcheesi?
Everything else is rated R, but for literally violence, the whole rest of the thing. Like, it's, it gets. The violence gets insane. The devil's gonna come when the sun go
down. The devil's gonna come. Fuck this.
I like how even they hated it. This is true. Kids do play gory games. It's only 12:16. Okay, last chapter. This will be like 100% last chapter. I'm going to have to stop after chapter 3. Then tomorrow night, because I don't have to get up early after tomorrow night, I'm going to stop it after that. Oh, you meant the truth or dare stuff. Oh, okay. Well, that's understandable. Never mind. Oh, yeah, yeah. Truth or dare is definitely very dangerous, especially like that. Yeah. Definitely, definitely dangerous. Can't blame you there.
You out here?
Nick!
Abby? Shout again!
I'm over here!
I'm coming!
Nick!
Hey.
Hey. Hi.
You ran off?
Yeah, it's already chapter 3 right now. I don't know where it would continue from if I stopped it, because I do have to go to bed to go to work, but I will stop at chapter 4, and after chapter 4, we'll full stop there. I'll play again tomorrow night when I get back. I don't know when that's gonna be. But I don't have to be up until later, like slightly later, so even if it goes to like 1 or 2 in the morning.
For me.
All good.
Hey. Yeah, I know what you mean.
So, all that stuff back there?
Oh my gosh. Emma really wanted to make Jacob jealous, huh?
You think?
I mean, yeah, why the heck else would she kiss me like that? I was just playing along.
Yeah. It's just a game, right?
Right.
This is where I make it gory. Also, yes, she did do that.
Mm-hmm. Should we look?
They got away from it? Hello? Oh, okay, never mind. I was about to say.
Is it another boar?
It's too growly.
Too growly. Good job, buddy.
Thank you.
did. Matt says, I don't care for her.
Oh, no! Oh, my God! Oh, my God! Oh, my God!
Oh, my God! Don't do anything. Let
him get you. Nick! Oh, my God!
Oh, she's gonna help him. Wow. Oh, there it is. Now she gets attacked too, huh? I like how she dipped and Nick is still there. All right, be Nick.
Shit.
Dang, bro. Jeez. She just got like gored. My goodness. RIP her shoulder. It said Gorefest, and I want to see more gore. There hasn't been like much gore. The most we've seen is the squirrel get murked. This is gonna be some like Friday the 13th type beat. Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Shit.
Yeah, let's go into a tree where the thing that can climb can easily get to us. That's a great idea, man. Good job, Ed. Let's say she's screwed. Hello? How does she get out of there so fast? I think must have been like distracted or something, because what the freak? Ain't no way. Yeah, exactly. It's supposed to be Gorefest, not Safefest. Facts. I want every single one of them to die. Or only one of them survives and every other character in the game dies. You just remembered you don't like bad endings. We'll see how bad these endings are. I have no idea, to be honest. She's holding her breath pretty well here, so it might not be that bad of an ending. Oh, oh no! Oh, there's the gore. She's got like her neck. Was that her shoulder again? That's kind of weak. Yeah, she got like bit in her shoulder, so is she gonna turn too? It's cutting me so deep, half the clothes. Yeah, that's true. This one doesn't say that they all die or they all live or anything, so it just says it's the most gory options possible. It's only worth it if it hurts.
Technique needs work.
Hey. Yeah. I guess you found that.
Of course.
I thought it was her face, too, but then it kind of looked like her shoulder when she got up and started running again.
A little more fun.
Or whatever it was.
I could get caught, huh?
Yeah, I guess.
Jacob, I thought we agreed that this, us, was just supposed to be some summer fun.
Yeah, no.
That guy is based on you. Just... Oh, man. R.I.P.
You just love having...
Sorry, Maruka.
Jacob.
I mean, I can't believe you fucking Frenched him.
You know, in front of everyone. Jesus wept.
French, are we 12?
No, but Nick is. Kind of. You know, I love the guy, but I don't think he's actually ever seen a girl naked before.
Well, I hate to break it to you, but he just had his tongue down my throat, and he definitely knew what to do with it.
Yeah, you really thought that was going to make better, huh?
Lighten up, Sourpuss, please.
This is not how the night was supposed to go.
What?
You know what? Nothing.
No.
Nothing, never mind.
Hey, that's mine.
Yeah, well, finders keepers.
I'm getting it back tomorrow. Fine. You can stand here, sulking. Driving yourself crazy imagining Nick's tongue in my mouth.
Ah, come on.
Or you can go grab us some towels.
What do you need towels for?
Well, we agreed. Summer fun, right? Apparently, summer is not quite over.
Okay.
This next part's like what confused me the most, to be honest. Not this part, but like something later. We'll see in a minute. Whoa. It's a dead body.
We'll see about that.
Now we'll have to just wait and find out. Now won't we, Fuzzy?
It's not long ago. Wonder if it was near here. Chackett and Thackett, huh? Oh, well, Chackett must mean Mr. H. Chris Hackett. Who the hell is Thackett? Looks like somebody didn't put their oars away. Still wet.
It's a little suspicious.
What are these numbers?
Manageable, but unsustainable. I missed so much on my playthrough, apparently. My goodness.
Whoa. Someone up there? I'm gonna go with probably everything's fine. God damn it.
There's no towels!
None?
There's exactly zero.
You dick.
God, what the hell?
Just get back down here, Jacob.
Okay, well, I guess we could just, like...
This is what I was talking about. This is she...
And we could shake it out doggy style.
Wow, you really know how to talk to a girl, don't you?
She just teleports out of her clothes, and it's really funny. It just makes absolutely zero sense on how that even happens.
Oh, but I can, because, you see, oh, help! Help, I'm drowning, and I need a big, strong, not at all insecure man to come save me.
Yeah, well, why don't you ask Nick? Okay, I'm sure he'd love to rescue you. I'm ignoring you.
Oi. Oh! Dang.
Gotcha.
What the hell, man?
Oh, okay. Okay, now you're gonna get it. See?
Hey, Glitch!
Oh, stop being wrong.
Attack!
Hey!
Yeah, I know. The water physics are absolutely beautiful, huh? I'm sure this game would look so much better if I actually had a PS5.
Dick move.
Dang.
Look, I don't want this to end.
I'd be happy to stay out here all summer, but I think we'd get a little pruning.
Oh, you know what I mean, like... this.
Jacob, I had a great summer with you.
Well, it doesn't just have to be the summer.
I actually never saw Resident Evil Village, to be honest, which I wish I did.
A backflip.
I kind of messed up by not doing it.
You let me come visit you, okay? How about that? Right. Hey! Where you going? Come on!
Yeah, because she wants to see you do a backflip, buddy. Super proud of you there. Well, that's a little suspicious now, isn't it, buddy?
Oh, gotta be fucking kidding me.
Jacob?
Ugh, Dick.
Yeah, because he definitely abandoned you. Absolutely nothing else is going on right now. Oh, yikes. Now you're drowning. Did we lose one character already? You got out. You didn't lose him yet. Oh, man. Yeah, see, that would have been more useful if you actually decided to do it the proper way and not, you know, dive directly down like that for it, huh? Oh, where are we at now? Are we on the... Oh, okay, yeah. I remember where this one's at. I did pick the Gorefest.
Some mighty fine social disruption there, Kaylin, I have to say.
I did pick the Gorefest. I made sure.
You're an evil genius.
Who do you think is going to make the first move? Nick or Abby?
Ooh, good cue. My bet's on either.
Let's see.
I don't know. Nick's got the beast in him.
If by beast, you mean some sort of mild-mannered baby deer.
Hey, don't let that cute, preppy aesthetic fool you. It's like a steel barbecue grill under that shirt.
So, you noticed that too, huh?
So, what do you guys want to do now?
We can keep playing.
Yeah? Just the three of us?
Alright, Dylan. Truth or... I sound like Abby.
Oh my gosh.
We gotta help her.
Wait, where did it come from?
This way. Come on.
Let's find out.
Abby! Help!
Oh,
please! Nick! Help him!
Where's Nick?
I left him behind because I got scared
go
and there was
Nick.
A monster man.
Go!
Okay, I got this.
Fess up to your crimes, Abby. Whoa, jeez.
That
she chucked
got a
it
hell
at him.
Spread. Be careful.
Yeah, let's throw the shotgun at the guy who looks like he's never shot a gun before in his life and acts like he is very awkward about every single situation in the world, eh? Perfect. Absolutely beautiful. Nothing bad could have happened from her chucking a shotgun at him like that. Oh, goodness. I want to see which pathway it chooses for him, because I remember I did all the shortcuts. I did one shortcut and one safe way. He's gonna fall. Freaking it. Oh, dang. Ah, he's making pretty good time. Man, he's kind of putting it. Oh. Oh, come on, buddy. Oh, you're getting there. Nice. Good job. She gave a gun to the creepy silent guy. Yeah, that's also true. He doesn't talk much. That kind of makes it even more suspicious there, doesn't it? Ah, goodness. Okay. Makes sense to me. I don't know. On. But he like broke his ankle for a second there. What just happened? He missed like for 0.2 seconds. Oh, yeah. Never mind, I saw that. Okay, I made pretty good time the first time. No, I didn't say this time was pretty good time. Oh, let's see what happens. Let's see what happens. Does he shoot him? Shoot him, right?
Stop,
shoot him.
Stop. I'll shoot.
Do it, nut nuts. Oh, he's gonna shoot Nick instead. He just lets him get away with it. Sorry, Nick. Bye, buddy. Oh, jeez. Okay. Oh, he bit him. Wow. Okay. I see why they mean Gorefest. Nick ended up biting him. And he's a werewolf.
Holy shit, dude. Dang.
Gotta get, we gotta go.
Can walk?
Can. Come on, gotta go.
Jeez, brother. That was insane. Man just blew his own finger off for no reason. Big dude definitely knows his stuff. Facts. This is very big facts. What's going on there, buddy?
Fuck. Oh, Jesus. There's a half-naked girl waiting for you back there, Jacob. What are you doing?
There's creepy noises, Abby? You don't know what's going on. Let's yell out into the woods.
No.
Jacob is absolutely dumb, but also, yeah, Might as well just say he is beat.
Who the fuck are you? Fuck you, you fucking asshole!
Good job, buddy. Yeah, keep yelling at him.
Oh,
like
Jesus
that.
Christ, what the fuck are you doing? Son of a bitch! What are you doing?
Shh. Quiet.
Distraction.
Good job, numbness.
Damn it.
Yeah, let's throw dirt at the guy who was, you know, helping you. To be fair, he was covered in blood, so I guess it makes a little bit of sense, but still.
It was.
Come on, buddy.
It was, I don't even know what it was. It was so fast.
Chapter
four.
Chapter four. We're gonna stop it here. Sorry about that, Maruka. You kind of missed a little bit. I don't know where your Wi-Fi went out, but Jacob got captured by the big dude after he blew his finger off because he got bit, and then yeah. That's kind of like the last little part of what has happened, but hey, I mean, dang, that was nice. I feel like that's a good kind of stopping point. It leaves you a little bit on the edge of what you wanna, you know, like see next. But we're on chapter 4. There's only 10 total chapters. I'm hoping it'll let me skip the epilogue, or I might just end it after the epilogue and just like let it run by itself, because my goodness, Fuzzy can attest to it, the podcast went on for like 25 minutes, I swear. But yeah, anyways, if you want to watch the full thing, I do have every single like the playthrough that I did myself. I still have it on my channel, so if you wanted to watch that, you can. I think I did like an hour and a half to 2 hours, about, yeah, like closer towards 2 hours, for every single episode leading up to it. But yeah, it definitely felt a lot longer than 25 minutes. I think it was actually only like 20 minutes total, the epilogue, but it felt like it was so, it felt like it was like 40 minutes long, because it just so it wasn't bad, don't get me wrong, the podcast was kind of funny, but also at the same time it was not the wave. Yeah, it was funny, but it was just, it was, yeah, it was bothersome and annoying. But yeah, so if you want to watch like the full parts, it is definitely part of it. Upload the videos to my YouTube. I'm gonna upload the videos to my YouTube. I'm gonna figure out, I need to download them, I think, to my PC, and then put them on to, like, upload them back to my YouTube channel. So I'm gonna try and download them tomorrow, I think, while I'm at my parents' house, and then do it then. But yeah, so I'm gonna end tonight. We'll come back tomorrow. I believe I work slightly later on Tuesday than I do tomorrow. But yeah, so we'll try and do more chapters tomorrow, depending on how early I get back home. We'll see on how many chapters I end up doing. It may be like a 3 to 4 hour long thing, and we'll finish the entire rest of it. It may be like an hour and a half, 2 hours, but we'll see. We'll get there when we get there. But yeah, anyways, so I appreciate y'all for coming out, by the way, like, for real. I really do appreciate it. I know I wasn't really like playing the game, so it probably wasn't as like fun or funny as it could have been, because I would have had some stupid reactions. Like I said, you can watch the videos that I have on my Twitch uploaded currently from the past broadcasts. But yeah, so like I was saying, I really do appreciate y'all coming out. I'm going to have to head to bed now, unfortunately, since I do have early work tomorrow. But yeah, anyways, I appreciate y'all coming out. Have a wonderful night, or morning, or afternoon. And I will see you guys later. Have a good one. Peace.